folks. Welcome to another Art Studio Chat. Rod Moore with you again. Just wanted to take a moment in this week's Art Studio Chat to talk to you about how you can really get going as a beginner painter. So in order to do that, I want to share with you my story. Some of you have heard it and some of you, this will be the first time. But I didn't start painting until I was later in life. I wasn't a child, you know, genius, or I wasn't painting and drawing in my early adulthood. I didn't study art. So what happened for me was I was working in an office in Elstonwick in Victoria, and I was running a marketing company, and I broke my coffee mug. Now, those who know me know that I love my coffee, right? I broke my coffee mug and I thought, oh, this is a bit of a disaster, but there's a $2 shop next door. I'll go down there and I'll buy myself a new coffee mug, which is what I did. Picked up the coffee mug in the aisle, and as I turned around, I literally found myself in the art supplies section. And my little heart started going like this, right? There's all those colors and brushes and canvases. And I thought, wow, I would love to be able to paint. Just this little passing moment. And this voice in the back of my head said, buy everything, right? Just buy everything and take it all home with you. And that's what I did. I bought as many colors and brushes and canvases and things that I could carry up to the counter and bought it all. And I went home that weekend. I did my very first little painting. And it wasn't very good because I really had no idea what I was doing. I had all these colors and I didn't know how to mix any of them to get the color that I wanted. All these different brushes, and I didn't understand what they were used for, how you use them to apply paint to a canvas. And so I made a mess, and then I did what most people do whenever they try something new, like painting or trying to play guitar or whatever. When they first have a go at it and they don't get the result they're looking for, they assume they have no natural talent. So I packed everything into a box, the box went under the bed, and I didn't look at it again for another 2 years. In 2008, I walked into a gallery in London, the Tate Britain Gallery. I saw the J.W. Turner paintings on the wall, and again, I had that intuitive nudge that I just knew that one day I was going to become an artist. And so that reignited my desire to want to have another go, right? But the problem was, and this is what I see with so many beginners, and if you really hear what I'm about to share with you, it will help you fast track yourself in learning how to paint. Now, it won't make you an overnight sensation or anything like that. There's no such thing, I don't believe. But what it will do is it'll get you on the right path. Now, I don't say this lightly. I say it because I've taught hundreds of students in one-day workshops and 25,000 students now around the world through the Learn to Paint Academy. And just about every beginner, what they do is overcomplicate the process. And this is what I did, right? I'm in that $2 shop. I bought a coffee mug and I bought 37 different colors, right? And 20 different types of brushes with no clue on how to use any of it. And so I see this time and time again with beginners, is that they tend to do the same thing. They try and use way too many colors, too many brushes, too many different types of surfaces to paint on, and try and put too many details and too many steps, and on and on it goes. Everything becomes overcomplicated. And so I felt this frustration in myself initially, but also in my students in the classes when I'd teach the workshops. So I thought to myself, what would happen if we started taking things away, right? And I thought, well, what's the bare minimum that you need to be able to produce a good painting? And really what the bare minimum is, when you look at the colors in a painting, you only need the three primary colors plus white. So the very first thing I did was reduce all the other colors out of the equation, because color, you know, paint manufacturers, the Winsors and Newtons and everyone else, Art Spectrum and Atelier Interactive, you know, they want to produce as many different colors as they can because they want to make sales, which is completely understandable. And as an advanced painter, some of those more exotic colors do come in handy. But when you're trying to start out learning how to paint, you don't need all those colors. What you need is to understand how to mix blue with yellow to get a green, and then how to get different variations of that green by adding a little bit of red and a bit of white to tint it and so on. So you need to learn how to mix color. And the problem so many beginners have is they know how to mix mud, right? Which is not the result that they want. Now, I've been there, mixed a lot of muddy, dirty, yucky colors in my life, right? So by simplifying it right down, and this I think is the real big key to helping beginners get started painting and get on the right track fast, is to simplify everything down. So I simplified it down to just three basic colors and white, and all of a sudden my students' paintings started to look more harmonious, more together, color-wise, right? It's greater color harmony. And then we reduced the number of brushes that they had. So we reduced the number of brushes down to just a couple of brushes, right? And if you've seen my videos, Learn to Paint TV, or any of the other videos that I do, you probably know that I use basically flat brushes, and I use hog hair bristle brushes, in a couple of different sizes, a large, a medium, and a small occasionally. And I use a palette knife occasionally, right? So I've simplified it right down to a handful of brushes. And, when it comes to painting surfaces, we generally paint on stretch canvas of a medium quality. So if you get the real cheap stretch canvas, you're not going to get good results. But if you're a beginner and learning to paint, you don't want to pay a fortune for Baldrian linen and things like that. Get a medium range stretch canvas, right? So now we've got three colors, we've got a couple of brushes, and we've got a medium quality canvas to paint on. Now we've simplified our tools right down, and by simplifying, we're less likely to become overwhelmed, we're less likely to have uncertainty because which brush do I use with what color and so on, and everything becomes easier, and we just push aside all the clutter, right, and we simplify right down. And then the other thing that I noticed, and this is when I created the Moore method of painting, is that people would overcomplicate the painting process. So when I started learning to paint, I found it really, really hard. I couldn't find a good artist who could articulate clearly what it was that they were doing. Most of the workshops and the classes I went to, the artists would demonstrate by doing a painting themselves with very little conversation and explanation. And so they do a great demonstration, but you'd stand there for an hour and a half watching them. And then, okay, now it's your turn, right? So you turn around and you go to your blank canvas and you go, okay, what was the very first thing that they did, right? So there was no process. So I simplified the process down through observation. I watched hundreds of DVDs of my favorite artists, and I noticed patterns in what they were doing. And I noticed that basically every painting goes through three very distinct phases, which is what we now teach in the Moore method of painting. There's the basic drawing to place big shapes on the canvas or the surface. Then there's the blocking, where we start to establish our values and we get color down to get rid of the white paint. And then we have the refinement process, where we put in details, we tighten up areas that need to be, and we lose edges where we need to lose edges, and we put in highlights and all those little finishing touches, right? Every good artist that I saw went through three very distinct phases: drawing, blocking in, and refinement. And so they all had their own approach within those three stages, but just about every artist I've ever seen paint goes through those three stages, right? So when I observed that, I started to apply that to my own painting improved. Then I started teaching that in our one-day workshops, and I noticed all of a sudden my students were all getting much better results. And then I started teaching it through our online courses and Learn to Paint TV, Learn to Paint Academy, and I started getting emails from all around the world of people saying, hey, wow, this really works. So what have we done? You know, what have we done to help so many students around the world be able to get on the track to learning how to paint? Well, what we've done is we've simplified it right down. And this is the big lesson for today. Simplify it down. You need three colors, the primary colors, right? And there's different palettes that you can make up. You know, I use a particular palette for landscape painting, but I'm starting to do more semi-abstract type work and bolder colors. So I'm changing my basic primary color palette, right? But you need a simple palette of primary colors. You need a handful of brushes that you know how to use. And you need a very simple process to go through, right? Now, this is not formulaic, because everyone's going to develop their own style and approach on how they move through those very distinct three phases of painting, but at least it gives you a framework, a simple framework for you to follow. So the message for today, for this week's episode of Art Chat, Art Studio Chat, is to simplify everything right down, right? If you're not getting the results you're looking for, just bring it all back to basics, three colors, three brushes, three steps, and follow us at the Learn to Paint Academy, and you'll start to get much better results. And then once you've got a good foundation in those simple, in our simple approach, you can then add layers to that as you go, right? You don't have to be refined by what we teach. It's a starting point to get you from beginner to intermediate. Once you get to intermediate, you can then express yourself with greater artistic flair on top of that. But right now, if you're starting out and you're a beginner, or you've been painting for a while, but you're not getting the results you want, simplify things down, and I guarantee you'll get much better results. Hope that helps. Look forward to seeing you next week on Art Studio Chat. Cheers for now.